folks. This is your host, Tammy Turner, and you are now listening to the Tiara Talk Show. We bring you rare interviews with the makers of Disney magic. Whether they be singers, actors, imagineers, animators, they've all made their mark on the Disney name. To find out more about the show and other episodes, head to our official website at www.thetiaratalkshow.com. Be sure to look below at the show notes in the Show More section for links to our Twitter and Facebook pages, including videos and websites mentioned in the following interview. Photos and audio clips that are featured in the show belong to their rightful owners and are used for educational purposes only. All guests' opinions are theirs and theirs alone and do not represent the opinions of the Tiara Talk Show or the host. The Tiara Talk Show is not associated with the Disney Company. Thanks again for tuning in to this week's episode, and from all of us here at the Tiara Talk Show, have a hoop-de-doo day. I'm excited to welcome this week's Tiara Talk Show guest, actress and voiceover artist Cyndi Vicino. Welcome, Cyndi.
Hi, Tammy. How are you?
Doing wonderful. So before we talk about some of your acting and voiceover credits, can you talk a little bit about your first voiceover job?
My first voiceover job. Wow. My first voiceover job was a radio commercial, and it was for a tuxedo store. Never done anything like that before, and the other two people had more experience. I was very young at the time. I was just winging it. I was just watching everything they were doing. If they marked their copy, I marked my copy. I didn't know what I was marking, but I did it. And that's how it all started. Most of my work was in Florida, so I did a lot of character voices, and there were a lot of dialogue spots, so I did a lot of dialogue spots, which I really loved doing.
And one of my favorite roles that you've ever done, it's a Disney role, of course. You played Inez in Belle's Sing Me a Story Disney Channel TV series. And for those who do not know what Belle's Sing Me a Story, basically it was a TV show that was played on Disney Channel in the early 90s, late 90s. It mixed live action, puppetry, and animation to talk about the problems the kids of the town might have, whether it be making the right decision or to keep on trying no matter what. And so you played the character Inez, who was a mail lady. She came in and dropped off some awesome mail for Belle. So can you talk a little bit about your character and how you landed the role?
Well, you know what's funny? I'm flattered that you got in touch with me and to allow me to go down memory lane, because when I heard from you, I thought, yeah, wait a minute. Let me dig that VHS out. And unfortunately, I still have a VCR. So
it's a good thing. Good thing. I still have mine too.
Yeah, you never know when you're going to need it.
I know, right? Yeah.
If you're a pack rat like me and you keep everything. Ah, yeah. And I watched it, and it brought back a lot of really pleasant memories. And I was trying to remember how I got the part. I don't remember. I think I know I never auditioned for it, which is really strange because every actor remembers every audition they've gone to. And so all I can think of is my agent called me and told me to be where I needed to be. And that was it. I went and I did the job.
And it was one episode, correct? It wasn't a couple of episodes.
It was one episode, yes.
Oh, I wanted them to bring Inez back.
Would have been fine with me.
So what was it like working with the kids and the actress who played Belle?
You know, I don't have any bad memories, so so it must have been very, very pleasant. Actually, it was. The set was terrific. Everyone was very nice, and the kids were terrific, and Lindsay was terrific. And it was kind of like a bada bing, bada boom kind of shoot. We just did it. The only thing I remember, and it's something that I was always tucked away in the back of my mind, and when I watched the show after you had contacted me, it was like, ding! I remembered this moment. I remember that the whistle didn't work, because when I came in, you know, when I blow the whistle and I go, all hail, the mail's here, the whistle was very, very weak, and I thought, well, they'll just fix that in post. I guess they never did. There's this very weak whistle.
It's a funny noise, though. I think that's what they were trying to go for.
Maybe they were going for her exhaustion, yes. But my goodness, you know, it was 19 years ago.
I miss seeing it on Disney Channel. And Disney has never released any of the episodes except for 3, if I'm counting correctly. There were 2 VHS tapes that were released with full 30-minute episodes. And I'm guessing that you have yours. I have both of them. And then there's also a DVD that was released with the sequel to Beauty and the Beast. I forget what it's called, but it's the animated version. And then there was another episode included with that, which I have not found yet. So I don't know if it's the same as the ones on the tape, but somebody posted your episode on YouTube, and it's pretty grainy. It's not too great. So I will post the link in the description below if people would like to check that out. I know there's plenty of eBay and Amazon copies of the VHS tape, so if you want to look for it, Belle, Sing Me a Story. Hopefully Disney might re-release it, because I thought it was a great transition for kids to connect what they were seeing on screen with books, because at the very end, the characters would suggest books for kids to read. I thought that was a great idea.
You know, it's funny. The Sing Me a Story has come up in conversation with some people, not in the biz, and they said, "Oh, I used to watch that when I was a kid. It was kind of weird, you know." just the happenstance of it—you contacting me, and then all these people talking about the show. I'm very honored that the show I was in was one of the shows was released.
I love the set to the show. I thought that was very interesting. So many books, comfy chairs.
The set was wonderful. And it was very easy to work on the set. I mean, because it just flowed. It was like being in a little bookstore. So, you know, I mean, there's always blocking and everything you have to do in a show, but everything just moved very easily. I'll tell you, I mean, when I watched it recently, and I hadn't seen it in years. It was like, it was all coming back to me, and yet some of it seemed new.
And did you guys have a read through with the script at all? Or did you just go ahead and shoot right away and you had to know your lines by then?
No, I just came on the set. Whether the original cast had a read through, that's possible. But I'm telling you, someone told me to show up somewhere, learn these lines, and there's your job for the day.
Have you done any other voiceovers for the Disney company?
There was another show called Thunder in Paradise. It was Hulk Hogan and Chris Lemon and Carol Alt. That was shot at Disney, and I was part of the Loop group. Looping is like the best job. It's usually, it's a group of people, and you're seeing the, say you're in a restaurant and you need that ambient sound, we show up at the studio, and we would see the scenes for the first time, and say it was on a beach. Sometimes you would just go in a circle around the microphone, or they would select certain people to do certain things. So you're on a beach scene, and it would be like, "Hey, throw me the ball!" And then they kind of mishmash it all together, and it's the din in the background. I love looping.
So now I have 3 questions I always ask all of my guests. They're called the Fab 3 questions. The Donald one is, as a child, what was your favorite Disney film to watch over and over again?
If I can excuse myself from saying a film, what I would say is I used to watch the original Mickey Mouse Club. Oh my goodness, I'm dating myself.
When I was a little girl, the original Mickey Mouse Club, I used to make my mother do my hair like Karen. She had banana curls, and I had real long hair. I was a very little girl, and she used to have to take like strips she would take like little rags, like cotton or something, and she would wrap my hair so I would have banana curls. So I'm sorry I haven't come up with a movie, but that, if you go back into my childhood, that's what I would say. I would watch the Mickey Mouse Club.
And now our goofy question is, what Disney character do you think would be your best friend if you met them in person?
Oh, Minnie. Minnie's the one. She'd be my BFF.
And our Mickey question, the final one, if I asked you to name any Disney song at this very moment, what immediately comes to mind?
When You Wish Upon a Star. And going back to your Donald question, if I had to pick a movie, it would probably be Fantasia.
But thank you so much, Cyndi, for coming on the show. It was very exciting. Also, check out Belle's Sing Me a Story TV series. Again, I'm going to post a link to to Cyndi's episode below in the YouTube comments. It might be removed from YouTube at some point in time, but hopefully it'll still stay up there. It's been up there for a couple years, apparently. But mm-hmm. It's a great episode. Wonderful to watch. I hope Disney releases the other episodes too, then people can be more acquainted with the show and see you, Cyndi, as Inez. Even yes. though it's one episode, it's okay.
I had a good time.
And listeners, if you guys want to, you can check out Cyndi's website.
Thevoiceoverpro.com.
And if you need somebody to do a voiceover for you, Cyndi is the gal.
She am the gal. Call me. Google me. I enjoyed talking with you. Thank you very much. I really appreciate it.
Remember, keep on trying.
Thanks, Big Book. Bye.
Bye. Bye.